Someone was in our backyard next to our dog last night. When my husband came out with his gun, the unknown was gone. Since then, our dog has disappeared. I want to file a complaint. I'll call the police in a few minutes.
Amy, as you already know, I don't trust these people. Neither the government nor anyone else, and you shouldn't trust them either. We founded our neighborhood watch for such cases. I don't want to see a policeman in Greyhill.
Brandon, I want this to stop. The whole thing has been going on for several weeks. I'm really afraid. After all, several animals have already disappeared. And Grandma Mary is... Oh, we should have already reported it to the police long ago.
I know that's a hard case, Amy. The neighborhood watch takes care of it. It's Ryan's turn today. He will visit you tonight during his tour. He isn't an elite soldier, and he wasn't in the Vietnam War either. But you know he played baseball as a professional. He can handle the bat. In addition, you can sleep better at night if you remember that a neighbor is patrolling outside, even if he can't hold on to his wife.
Leave him in peace. It's hard enough for him to deal with his situation.
Let me finish. Don't tell the policeman anything. Otherwise, we all end up in the psychiatric ward. Are you trying to tell them we think there are little green men running around?
Gray, Brandon. They are gray. But Amy, trust me. You don't want to end up in the psychiatric ward. Since that special incident in my childhood, I've spent my entire youth in a psychiatric ward. I've paid a high price to break free. The only way to escape was...
I can't hear that anymore. You've told your stupid story 1,000 times. In Vietnam, we went through something like this basically every day.
What does Vietnam have to do with it? However, for 2 weeks, I wear my tinfoil hat when I'm going out of the caravan. I believe they can control us through their telepathic abilities. I'm convinced that the hat protects me.
Brandon is right. They won't help us. They would rather make our lives hell. But I would still prefer if an officer stopped by here.
You know, I almost drank petrol last week. I forgot I put it in a Coke bottle.
Bob, shut the fuck up. Amy, I forbid you to call the police. Ryan, you can hear me, right? My daughter didn't talk the whole day. When she was in the forest with your son in the morning, there was a strange noise and Henry was curious about it. He went closer to it. Rachel ran home, but Henry stayed there. Henry went home later, right? What has he seen there? Rude kid. Instead of saving my daughter, he let her alone and she had to run home by herself.
Brandon! That's enough! It's been 2 months since his mother left me. Henry still isn't talking to me. He just can't get over it, so mind your business. I'm glad he has your daughter to hang out with. Rachel's a good kid. I was sleeping the past few hours because of my shift tonight. I think Henry came home a few minutes ago. I heard him lock himself in his room. But he's probably just watching TV like always. Anything to avoid talking to his old man. I think he'll come out soon.
What? They went to your house together, Ryan. Henry wasn't alone. Definitely not alone.
No, Rachel has been home for several hours. You're crazy, Bob.
Ryan, you really need to talk to Henry.
I know what I've seen. I'm not crazy, Brandon. However, it was very dark. Ryan, just take a look at Henry now. Guys, you need to board up your windows and doors. Now, if you haven't done it yet. I'll try to rest a bit.
That's a great idea, Bob. I'll reach out to the other neighbors, telling them to board up all the stuff just until this shit is over and everything is all right again. The fact is, the government is hiding something from the people. Things like this didn't just happen here in Greyhill. It started with Roswell, but it's been increasing since the 60s.
That's the way it is. Oh, Ryan, my kitty cat. Please, look for her during your shift. I'm really lonely without her.
Sure. Rachel and Henry are more important right now. But if I could find your cat, I'll let you know. Okay, Bob? I'll try to talk to my kid now, but that's if he'll talk to me. Call me if there's something new.
Don't forget to visit us later, Ryan. We'll make some coffee for you.
Yeah, sure. Thanks, Amy.
still hasn't fixed the TV.
Henry, tell me what you saw in the forest today.
You should ask Rachel, that crazy girl.
Henry, is someone in your room? Is Rachel in there?
God, I hope not. She should stop bothering me.
What's going on with you, Henry? Tell me! Who's there?
I'm going to your room, Henry. Stay here. Someone was in your room. They went out the window.
Max is barking! Fuck this hell.
Shouldn't do that now.
Oh!
Shouldn't do that now.
Stop barking! Who's there?
Fuck!
Is someone in the shed?
Max, be quiet!
What the hell?
Find something to break this door. Thank you.
break this door.
No, Max!
Sounds like the neighbors are boarding up their windows. I guess I should do the same. We should all do the same. Man, I hope this is over soon. What the hell was that light?
Dad, it wasn't Rachel, right?
Yeah, he locked the door and ran out of the roof. It's okay, he's gone now. But there was a strange light. Look, the TV. It's working now.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Lunatics and conspiracy theorists claim to have seen a UFO. The minority tries to convince other people that the small green aliens are real. The government has checked into this incident and has announced that this UFO, fortunately, is just a weather balloon. This movement that you'll see in a few seconds is just a reflection on the lens of the camera. There is no reason to concern. And don't forget to be aware of the small green man in your backyard. Your Mr. Broker.
That is not a weather balloon. They're lying. The government is lying and they're trying to hide it from us. Brandon was right. They're already in Greyhill. We can't talk about it to the police. They'll just lock us up in a psych ward.
Dad, we need to get out of this cursed place.
I shouldn't do that
now.
This
neighborhood hole.
Ryan, are you there?
I'll go talk to Brandon. I'm here.
Ryan, something is wrong with Joe Parson, the farmer, you know? He called me a few minutes ago. He was very afraid. Then the radio connection became broken off by something. He is working on the field near your house. You must check immediately what happened to him.
Okay, I'll go check on him. By the way, someone was in Henry's room. They escaped out the window. I almost caught them in our shed. But there was a strange blue light. I'm sure they're here.
Pull yourself together. Have you seen the TV news? No one will help us. We're all boarding up our windows currently. I know how to shoot because of the Vietnam War, and you can handle the baseball bat. We will overcome this night and drive to our holiday home by tomorrow. Don't forget how I shot your son's hat off while wearing it when I was drunk at the barbecue last summer. Imagine how I can handle the gun when I'm sober.
Brandon! You still have to pay for that. But leaving town tomorrow sounds like a good idea. I'll keep you updated. Over and out. I shouldn't go that way. I think I'm going in the wrong direction. Maybe I should turn around. I think I'm going in the wrong direction. Maybe I should turn around. I don't think so. Damn it! Is on her head. I mean, it looks like Kitty. I should bring her to his caravan. He already boarded up his door weeks ago. I'll have to try the dormer window on his roof. think I'm going in the wrong direction. Maybe I should turn around. I shouldn't go that way.